offspring. Grant that your servants may hold fast in their lives to the sacrament they have received in faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You are Jews, indeed, all of you staying in Jerusalem. Let this be known to you and listen to my words. You are children of Israel. Hear these words. Jesus, the Nazarene, was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man delivered up by the set plan and for knowledge of God, you killed using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will fail me for, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God has sworn oath to him that he will set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his ways see corruption. God raised these Jesus, of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he performed the promise of the Holy Spirit that he received from the Father, as you all see and hear." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are my home. In place. soul rejoices, my body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the nether world, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption.
To announce the news to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go, tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." While they were going, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priests all that had happened. The chief priests assembled with the elders and took counsel. Then they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers, telling them, "You are to say, 'His disciples came by night and stole him while we were asleep.' And if this gets to the ears of the governor, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble." The soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has circulated among the Jews to the present day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are filled with joy today, Easter Day, and the whole church is filled with joy. The disciples were filled with joy when they met the risen Lord, and they were filled with courage to go out and proclaim the good news and to go into every country and even to be martyrs, witnesses, to die for the faith. That's why we know that this lie is not true, that they stole the body. If his body is stolen, people don't usually see the person afterwards. They usually don't bow down and embrace their feet. And they usually don't go out and tell everyone and then prove willing to die for their story. So this is the confirmation of the greatest miracle in the history of the world, the resurrection. And it was foretold, predicted. Jesus predicted it beforehand, he prophesied it, and the Old Testament readings, all of the prophecies of the Old Testament today, they read the Old Testament scriptures and they don't understand what they're reading, because these readings speak of this suffering servant who would die, but then be raised up on the third day. And then it happened. And so we have all of these confirmations and all these reasons to rejoice, so we can rejoice and be glad. And in the first reading, we have Peter doing just that, because Peter was really afraid. He was really scared. In fact, he swore three times. It says he began to swore, bestemyar. He began to hurrah, you know, call down curses upon himself. You know, this is serious for a Jewish person to swear. Hurrah, an oath that I did not know him. And that was very serious, they say. And they also say, I've heard some exorcists say that, you know, since Peter had this real aversion to the cross, he said, God forbid that this should happen to you. He was very afraid of crucifixion. He didn't really like watching people get crucified or look at crucified people on the way into town, because that's what there was back then. He really had a great fear of that. And so perhaps that was like an entry, and the evil one wanted to sift him like wheat, and he almost got possessed, or perhaps was influenced by the evil spirit. And then he called down these curses, but it was only at Pentecost. It says, this is the beginning of the Easter season. Every day is Easter. We're going to hear Easter stories this week. And we're going to hear every day one of the apparitions of the resurrection. I usually pray the first glorious mystery five times every day. Just the resurrection mysteries. There's five or six or seven different stories of the resurrection. So you could, you know, just have a mystery for each resurrection story. That's what I do. Because it's Easter day. Why would you meditate on anything else? There's lots of stories, and here we have this story of the holy women. But we also begin to read the Acts of the Apostles, how the church, the body of Christ, rose up, and Peter got up. What does it say? On the day of Pentecost, the day the Holy Spirit came down, 50 days after Easter, 50 days from now, the Holy Spirit came down upon Mary and the apostles, and Peter was exercised. He was freed, and he was not afraid anymore. And he got up. He stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews," he's going to start talking about the prophecies, all those wonderful predictions, and he's going to speak about that. And he gets up and he starts talking about whom? About Jesus the Nazarene, which means branch. Branch is the one who is predicted, who would be the shoot from the line of King David. A man mighty in deeds and wonders, whom God worked, and this man delivered up by a set plan and foreknowledge of God. You killed him, using lawless men to crucify him. Wow. Peter got the word out. Peter was able to say it. Crucify him. But he wasn't afraid anymore. Now he's going to speak it out and proclaim it like it's a good thing, like it's a glorious thing that Jesus. But God raised him, releasing him from the throes of death. Peter's not afraid anymore. He's talking very boldly, clearly, and succinctly, and deliberately about the details of this, of what happened to his Lord. And he is willing himself to die. And of course, how did he die? Crucifixion. I'm not worthy to be crucified. Crucify me upside down. I'm not worthy to be crucified like my Lord. because that's the set plan. All of this is the set plan and foreknowledge of God. The Old Testament, everything in the Old Testament, it's all going to come true. And we will, in heaven, have our minds filled forever with joy and amazement at the wisdom of God. Every little thing, not one jot or tittle of the Old Testament is left unfulfilled in the Catholic Church, in what we have, the body of Christ raised, and the life that is given to us in the sacraments. Saturday night we baptized people and anointed them, gave them anointing and baptism. And I was reflecting on the fact that anointing is for kings. A king in the Old Testament times, the tribe, the father gave the blessing or the inheritance, the anointing to the firstborn. And the firstborn got everything. They would fight over it to get this blessing, to be and to sit at the right hand of the Father, and to take on this role of leader, Christ, anointed one, king of the tribe, of the family, and also to be the leader of prayer was a priestly role. The firstborn was the priest initially in the Old Testament. And so this oldest one, but now we all get anointed. All of us get anointed. All of us become priests. We become kings, members of the royal family. Thrones and crowns are waiting for us in heaven. And so we rejoice that God has this set plan and foreknowledge of what's going to happen to Jesus, and then what is going to happen to us who in Christ is baptized into him. We become his brothers and sisters, members of the royal family, and rejoicing that we will be enthroned and glorified in heaven. As we said in the psalm, that it's not just for Jesus, it's for us. He has wonderful plans for us. Keep me safe, O God. You are my hope. Let us stand and pray. Let us pray for our Pope Francis and for our Bishop Myron and for the whole church, the body of Christ, that boldly we will proclaim the good news that is the hope for us and for the whole world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for the intention of this Holy Mass, for the intentions of the Lopez Ortega family, oremos por la familia Lopez Ortega. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for any prayers that you may wish to mention.
For persecuted Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocation to the priesthood in religious
life. For peace in the world and in the sanctity of family, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear the prayers of your children in Christ who lift up our prayers to you in the name of Jesus, our brother who died for us, but who rose again and lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
sisters, then my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
May the grace of this Paschal sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, O Lord. Accept graciously, we pray, the offerings of your peoples, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Be still and know peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to make this bread, but only to say the word, and my soul shall be
let us pray. May the grace of this Paschal Sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, O Lord, and make those you have set on the way of eternal salvation worthy of your gifts, through Christ our Lord. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.